3 years ago, Kampala City Council Authority embarked on a project to expand and line Luigi with concrete under a 513 billion shillings arrangement christened Kampala Institutional and Infrastructure Development Program. The World Bank-funded project, which was poised at containing huge water volumes, whose completion was meant to happen 2 years ago, has stalled due to encroachment which concerned COSASE.
Okay. Everyone that needs to be engaged should be engaged, because you cannot have year after year after year that there's a challenge with this area. It continues this way. So we have a lot of flooding that happens in many parts of Kampala. Why? Because places like this, which are meant to be huge catchment areas, are not fixed. So we are saying, can we move as quickly as we can? Where maybe Parliament's hand is needed so to get involved, engagements happen, and this place gets to be sorted out.
During a joint inspection with the Committee on Commissions, statutory authorities today, the KCCA Executive Director Dorothy Kisaka explained that the project has stalled due to land disputes.
It is partially done. Government committed funds for this project in 2020. We've had a challenge with some of the people who are making claims. And when a person makes claim on a place that you are working on, you have to first settle that claim before you finish the construction.
Information from KCCA indicates that as of May 2021, about 140 properties of the residents along the Luigi channel had been valued by the chief government valuer. Kisaka decried shortage of funds for distilling drainage channels.
Our challenge is budget. We don't have enough money for continuous desilting. And I'm glad Parliament can assist us with that, especially in this rain season.
National Environmental Management Authority statistics indicate that wetland coverage in Uganda declined from 15.6% in 1994 to 8.9% by 2017. However, the government has set its sights on increasing the wetland coverage to 9.57%, something analysts say is unrealistic. The committee also visited the swampy area at the Spear Motors Junction in Nakawa, which has been fenced off by unknown people pending construction. COSASE committee members opposed construction in the swampy area.
It's the owner of the petrol station which was built in the wetland. Again, we are going to
specialized.
Gaba Road. On Soya. There is a petrol station that was built in the wetland. It is the same person. Me, my appeal is to the enforcement team.
Yeah.
They are going to come back and...
Yeah, and put these things back here. So they're putting things back here every day.
COSASE also inspected the contested 10 acres of land in Kisenyi, which KCCA is covertly procuring from the city businessman Bosco Muwonge at an overpriced cost of 370 billion shillings.
And we hear the negotiations that are ongoing between KCCA and the owner, Ewan Bosco Muwonge, is asking for $100 million for the 10 acres. That's 38 billion, meaning he wants 38 billion per acre. We are saying no, that is not acceptable.
This land here, where ownership is being contested, for some of us who have been around, there is a primary school here and a court, KCCA court and Nabageka primary school. So we want to find out what happened to the school, who demolished the school and who was owning the school before we established who Monga is.
Senyonyi also led the committee to plot 71 Nkrumah Road, which had a KCCA dispensary and was irregularly allocated to the private investor. COSASE insisted that the property must be recovered.
Number two, these people were given a five-year lease, Ephraim Taganda and his colleagues. But then very quickly, the five-year lease was converted into a 45-year lease, 49 years, so they added 45 thereabout. And then very quickly, they converted the lease into freehold under very dubious circumstances. So now, Securex Amenities became perpetual owners of this property.
And my predecessor is the one who started this forensic audit. And the Auditor General has revealed several facts upon which even COSASE is building on. So we must uncover the rot which is there and put the city in order.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.